win against the Chiefs. They seem to get back on track. Back-to-back losses in prime time versus the Bears and the Eagles raised even more doubt if this team could take that next step. But after a first-round bye, the Rams opened their postseason with a physical win over the Cowboys using that ground game of Todd Gurley and C.J. Anderson, who combined for 273 rushing yards, setting up the rematch with the Saints. Just when it looked like the Saints, you guys, were marching to another victory, that controversial no call allowed L.A. back in the game, forced overtime. Drew Brees was intercepted on the opening possession. And we know what happened after that. Greg Zuerlein's 57-yard field goal sent the Rams to their first Super Bowl since 2001. So, as I mentioned earlier, Tom Brady's first ever Super Bowl was against the Rams. They meet again. It's hard to believe that this Rams team, you guys, was 4-12 in 2016. There was so much chaos there. The exit of Fisher, Sean McVay comes in, Jared Goff, can he get the job done? Some defensive adjustments. What do you make of this matchup with the Rams and the Patriots?
Go ahead, Tom.
I tell you
at the beginning of the season, the Rams and the Patriots, you were looking at yourself in the...
Yeah, I was looking at me.
You look great.
I was working on my hair game.
You look great.
Well, look, you think about the Rams last year.
Okay.
They were in a situation. Philly came, you know, Atlanta. Was it Philly or Atlanta? I think Atlanta beat them last year.
Yeah.
In the wild card game. But they had all the pieces. You know, they draft Goff. You have Gurley. They go out and make the trade for Brandon Cooks. They make the trade for Aqib Talib. They sign Ndamukong Suh. 2 years ago, they signed Andrew Whitworth. They short of their offensive line to protect the money, which is the quarterback and the running back. Mm-hmm. So I'm not really surprised. And they go get Wade Phillips a couple of years ago. So I'm really not surprised that they're here. Maybe how soon they got here.
So Lesney did a nice job. That organization did a nice job of making sure that they put the pieces in place.
Yes.
How do you think that they will fare against the Patriots?
Yeah, and so here's the thing. The Rams defense over the last couple of weeks have really played great. They are playing like they did at the beginning of the season.
Stopping the run.
They're locking down on the back end. They're playing great football. So now, how do they attack the Patriots? Do they get up and press them and say, we're not going to let these guys off the line. We're going to be in their face. We're going to be aggressive. Or do they drop back in zone?
We've seen
the Rams. I will be aggressive.
Wade is not a zone guy.
You got to be aggressive. And I'm sure they will. But they have to be able to get to Tom Brady as
Dion,
well.
Dion, how do you defend this team, the Patriots?
First of all, let's stop their run. Let's do this.
Yeah.
Let's stop their run because this is the way the Patriots have been winning the last few weeks.
Yes.
Let's stop their run. Secondly, you're going to have to get up there and be physical with the receivers because Tom Brady, he does not look to go vertical. Tom Brady,
he wants the ball out of his hand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got to figure out what is your matchup with Gronk. See, Gronk has been solid. He was deadly in a couple situations that they needed him to play big, and he played big.
Yeah.
But Gronk could turn it on. Gronk could catch 10, 15 balls like it ain't nothing if he's the one that you call on.
And do the Rams have a safety back there
that can deal with
Joyner?
Him?
Can he hang with Gronk? I don't know.
I don't know about that.
He's small.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know? That's a tough matchup.
That's a tough matchup.
Given their wide receiver situation and no one puts fear in me, I wouldn't be opposed to putting Aqib on Gronk, especially if they line him up out wide.
But now here's the other thing, guys.
I ain't mad at that.
How do the Patriots match up on the Rams? Do they put Stephon Gilmore on Brandon Cooks and take away the big play and let Robert Woods eat everything underneath?
If this defense is playing better football, which you guys all agree on, what's the weakness of the Rams in what you saw today?
To me, I think it's running on the edges. Mm-hmm. I don't think it's running right here. I think it's running on the edges.
Yeah. Yes. I agree.
Okay. We're going to take another look at the AFC championship game, shall we? See how the Patriots were able to have success again. Tom Brady looking to go to his ninth Super Bowl. Patriots ball 28-24, first and goal. Rex Burkhead, four-yard touchdown. The Patriots leading 31-28. Harrison Butker lined up for the 39-yard field goal, 11 seconds. Does his job. The Chiefs tie the game up 31-31. We're going to overtime. Patriots fall after converting three third downs on this drive. So we're looking at second and goal. Patrick Mahomes trying to fire up his crowd. Rex Burkhead silences the crowd. Patriots win 37-31. Here's Andy Reid after the loss.
It's going to hurt, which I could obviously see. That's important. That's how you get better. And this team has done that throughout the season. When the chips were down, we fought back and did a little bit in this game here, but we came up a little short. So let it drive you through the off season and have this feeling that hurt, and let that carry you through so that you don't experience it again.
The way we've been fighting all year long, the way the guys been fighting all year long, the way we fought this game, I mean, couldn't be more proud to be on this team, more proud to be out there with the boys, how hard we just kept fighting, defense, offense, special teams. And that mean a victory on the road, AFC championship game. I mean, it was one of my sweeter victories, definitely, in my career, for sure.
And Commissioner Roger Goodell was on hand. He's surprised some longtime Chiefs season ticket holders, Danbos, and with a pair of Super Bowl tickets Sunday at the AFC Championship. Goodell was accompanied by Chiefs CEO Clark Hunt and actor Eric Stone Street. It's part of the 500 Super Bowl tickets the league is giving away to community leaders, youth football coaches, and fans that have served our country. All very, very cool.
Let me get those tickets since Chiefs ain't going.
Despite the outcome, it was an amazing
football coach.
Coming up next on Game Day Prime. Todd Gurley spent much of the NFC Championship on the sideline, on that bike right there. So can the Rams win the Super Bowl if their star running back only gets five touches? We will discuss next.